Okay. So as the next oral talk, we have Michael Kosloff from the Leipzig Max Planck Institute from Leipzig. So, and he will tell us a little bit more about his actual topics. Michael, it's your turn.
Okay. Thank you, everybody, for attending this presentation. These talks. Partially is a summary of my previous investigation and partially for my latest, not only my, our team investigation, go in more detail simulation of human brain. Okay, what story, I very short because it's already was mentioned in the first talk, we need to know SAP. For our safety assessment. Yes, right now more and more question how to get temperature, but in any case, to simulate temperature, you have to know power deposition. Oops.
Sorry, I just want to start screen.
Yeah. And this has meaning that in any case, if we interested in temperature, we have to calculate SAR as first step. And the second, our major problem that we have rather limited number of anatomical model aware. For example, I aware only of two Korean model and virtual family from Edis Zurich, but all together it's no more than 20 models. And the second, our point of view, clearly I not time domain person. And as a result, voxel-based geometry is not suitable for frequency domain. And to get anatomical correct tissue is also necessary to get not only voxel, we need to get proper surfaces. And it will be discussed a bit later. Okay, what another my point also coupled to previous discussion of previous talk. When we discuss simulation, I prefer to follow actual fabrication and optimization stage of coil, because in such case I know how much my numerical domain compatible with my simulation. And first stage I do only 3DM simulation of model. Without capacitor and heat network and so on. Then I reconnect all this network to my setup. And this is in reality corresponds like you solve up your cups and so on. Then I doing circuit level optimization. It's corresponding to array tuning procedure, because when you build something, you start adjusting your trim capacitor or your inductor and so on to get your coil tuned. And finally, I compute magnetic and electrical field for each individual radioactive element or coil, dipole, doesn't matter. And this is really corresponding to physical measurement of array. And then if it's necessary, I do near field optimization, statical or PTX, it's finally not so critical, and calibration property for performance and so on. What behind this, if I do 3DEM, I remove all feet, all stuff, and I have only kappa structure in my numerical simulation, and plus definitely the electric. Then I go to circuit, and at circuit I reconnect all stuff back, and I get all stuff back, and this is your actual coil on bench. Clearly, I have two static magnetic field and so on and so on, but this setup is really your coil back. You have your old trim capacitor available. You could easily, just a second, change this cap's value and look on this parameter. Well, you don't need to rerun your long time domain simulation. It's only necessary to run circuit simulation until you get just a second year result. And using this approach, you immediately come to conclusion. It's necessary to use a frequency domain solver for such a project, because if you have 100 ports to run 100 time domain simulation, makes no sense. Well, at least it's very low. And the second, also my point, if you look on MRI coil structure, it's curve structure. And if you try to use a classical time domain mesh, then you need to get rather small mesh element, for especially dual row setup for a distance, not so large between different row. And by definition, for time domain, the smaller your mesh size, the longer your simulation. But you have not any chance to do anything for this fundamental stuff. And next point to this analysis, comparing to real coil and your numerical domain, is power budget. Because I have right now maybe 10,000 simulations of different coil, and I never get results that if I have the same power in human head. Once more time, size of object should be on length of water of fiber. Then you get the same B if you have the same power. From electromagnetic point of view, you have no chance to get magnetic field without electric field if your subject is caught away. And you're not doing PTX, once more time, two limitations. With PTX, the story is a bit different. But if you're not doing PTX, then you need power to get your setup. And if you know that you need power, then comparing of different coil finally go to this setup. How much power is reflected? If your coil not proper tuned and you get higher reflected, then you simply get smaller peak. And also how much you radiated. It's another story that what very carefully should be discussed, especially in numerical domain. When people compare different coil, because you should to include your magnetic ball. If you not include the magnetic ball for unshielded coil, especially for that setup, you get another radiated power in your numerical domain. Because travel wave is opposite. Because if your magnetic ball support travel wave, this means it support also radiation. And then you have to proper simulate your radiation. And clearly, losses in your element. Because you have to get all your caps value and so on. If you're doing this, then your power budget is converged. And very important that you have to show quantitative aggregate. Because if you, in your calculation, get one value for transmit and another value for this sum, clearly something from the element. And especially, as I mentioned, two fundamental known issues. First, radiated power, especially if boundary is very close. It's another problem of time domain. Always people try to get boundary as close as possible to get smaller number of mesh elements. And the second is convergence. Both it's valid for frequency and time domain. If you not converge your simulation, then you will get not proper power. Okay, another what I already touched is its point of view of my Max Planck Institute. We don't like single coil setup. In terms of, once more time, if one not using PTX. Our institute is focused on doing a lot of fMRI study, and thus we're not interesting to do field mapping and so on for every patient. We would like to do routinely our measure. And without PTX, if you have even 8-element array, with any kind of static shielding, you not get so much. You will see near the same setup. But if you go to dual row array, then without any kind of PTX, you get much, much better function. Because it's not only from our side, it's published by Avdeevich, some other groups, or experimental results, that for dual row array, you could get much, much better homogeneity without any kind of PTX. And you have very simple trade-off here. You have your B1 plus performance, and you have homogeneity. These curves also In other words, was a lot of time presented by PTX people. It's so called L curves. You pay for your homogeneity reduction of your B. No chance to win both B and homogeneity. But in this dual row setup, it's very simple. You simply adjust phase between two rows and amplitude of each row. The fact that for driving this coil, you need only two channels, individual PTX, not 16 channels, for example, like 16 elements of this. Okay, what was our last year study, what I tried to present more detail today? What we discover due to our human brain research study, that we have CSF with different shape in different people. And because it was noticed that B field change when we use these different people, we would like to check how this in numerical domain going on with CSF. And also is known from literature that CSF electrical property not fixed for different humans, for different ages, and so on. And then it was simple question, what's going on if I change electrical property from it is parameter. And finally, in this study, it was interesting how much resolution we could get. Because clearly, it is right now, show very high resolution time domain models. But as I mentioned, these time domain models not suitable for frequency domains. Array setup for this simulation was the same dual row. It was not investigation of array, it was setup what we use routinely. And in first stage, I compare ANSYS human model. It's well known more than 10 years human model. And VHP human model that become available last year from US university. And also advantage of this model, no, it's surface-based model. And with good measures that I have chance very simple to scale. But I could get smaller, larger by simple using scaling. Okay, what's appear from my numerical simulation? If I use ANSYS model, where I have no distinguished CSF, and VHP model, where CSF area was equal to gray matter, with a simple merge CSF in gray matter, then despite of different shape of this head, this is woman, this is man. I see near the same pattern. Yeah, a bit different amplitude, but not present. But if we include the CSF, then clearly we see some these maybe not good beamer or shielding effect. And this shielding effect more pronounced in this sub population. If you have CSF continuous, and it will be shown, just I go with these different slices, yes. You see that current go continuously through your CSF area, it's cross section. And this is tissue. Well, you have path to get your current. If you have voxel-based model and your voxel, due to voxelization and so on, not touch each other, that for CSF very easy because CSF is very thin. Then you get no chance to correctly represent this current flow. And this our calculation once more time push us in direction to look how realistically designed CSF and how CSF influence of our safety. When I did additional calculation with very small scaling factor, once more time, I would like to underline my first statement about power. If you get 0.8, then your head become very small. Then you not so much in wavelength condition. You become more near field. And then as you see in this near field, you don't see too much difference because you're not in area where your size is compatible to wavelength. Okay. This is slide for also for SAR. Once more time, practically no difference despite different head anatomy. But it's message from this part of my investigation, if you have child, for example, in your MRI scan, more safety region not so critical because you could approximate much easier. But if you have a person or patient with very large head, then story become more complicated. Okay, next part of this study, it clearly was artifact, but what we did, we tried to change CSF size by increasing or thickness on top or increasing area in where you have CSF inside brain in ventricle. And once more time, the same simulation, only difference in this case, we use two location of head. One classical where you in coil, and the second what also used right now from time to time where brain in middle. To get, if you're doing fMRI or so on, you're mostly interested in top region, then it's better to locate the head in middle of the coil. What appear from this, and this very clear show idea why we put in middle. If you look, sorry, value might be not readable, in middle you put your head, you will see that B1 plus become higher. No surprise, your field of view much smaller here. You not excite neck. You excite only what you need. Also, you see in this very clear that with continuous CSF, you get this shoot effect. Because CSF between this scalp and this area get clear. If we look on this artifact CSF modification, you immediately see two stories behind. First of all, if you put larger CSF and it's very elastic area, you get drop of B1 plus. This what behind a starting point of our investigation, in some patient we see a drop of B1 plus when we map. And this what we confirm from our simulation. If you have on top of your head high region of CSF, high thickness, then you simply get a drop of B1 plus because high conductivity. If you increase CSF in vertical, then it's small increase, not so critical. But if you get large increase, then your B1 plus also. If we look on SAR profile, no, in standard setup, no surprise. But if we go to this, you once more time, sorry, value not so much. Immediately see that SAR become much larger in this area where we have additional thickness and all in area where you get larger CSF. Clearly, numerical results show that if head is an entire coil, you will immediately see problem with CSF because CSF absorbs. And if you put head in middle, then you're more safe. Because in this case, only area with CSF on top for you critical. Different CSF in middle of brain, not so critical. And this is last part of my presentation, what I try to show our actual level, what we could simulate and what we could achieve. This is human brain. This very high resolution human brain is more resolution than it is. And this brain fully measurable in HFSS. For it, this is example of simulation of such brain. It's B1 plus. Definitely, it's plan wave excitation. It's not coil, because no sense to simulate such brain in coil. We right now have no entire head. It was first our attempt to look how precise we could get our brain. And another step-by-step improvement in our quality. This is already a brain with different tissue. As you see here, it's white great matter. This is cerebellum, also from white and great matter. This is CSF and ventricles inside. Once more time, this extremely high resolution model in plan wave setup fully simulated by HFSS.
Sorry, you didn't say high resolution. What's the number or what do you mean in terms?
Terms, this is a submillimeter. If you look on this area, we have 4.5 millimeter or less.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's really high.
Yes, this is as I mentioned. Definitely, if you have bulk setup, then you get much larger. But the smallest area between this white and gray matter is less than 0.5. And still it's fully, as volume is in model and in simulation. And it's simple example of also different what we try to look in our workflow. And once more time, in this we try to look how size of these CSF, these ventricles influence of our sound. But it's very simple, makes three different models. And clearly, if ventricles is very small, then you have very small power deposition. But if you get this very large setup, or even this much larger, then clearly you get much higher power deposition. Okay, conclusion of my presentation. Clearly, we think that FDA requirement is correct. We need patient-specific head investigation at 7 tests. It's both important for safety and for understanding of transmit performance of our. We used two model, clearly it's only two model and not so many up to now. But if we use the same volume, we see near the same people. And also clear that CSF conductivity is much for us. And we have maybe invest more in this tissue mapping technique to know electrical property of human head, living head, because clearly we have no chance to measure this. And as I mentioned, we always underline that it's only case study. We need more human model to do and to look or to get more broader. The second part of my conclusion is that it's important clearly to look on head location when you put in coil, especially if you're doing something like fMRI or any kind of study that not require coverage of entire. Then you could get simple your safety situation by location head in middle of. And clearly when we change CSF space, it's also change our safety asset. And last part of my conclusion, clearly I use commercial software. Once more time, I never pretend that I'm selling this software or so on. I'm using this commercial software because it's when I started all my research, it was the best frequency domain solver. And I use this frequency domain solver for my industry. But I clearly should notice that actual stage of this solver is in situation that solver is very fast, but all geometry proceeding is much, much slower compared to my simulation. Call it, if I look on this simulation of high resolution brain, I use only 5% of my time to simulation, to solver. 95% is importing model, generation of mesh, and so on, and post-processing. Still two words between solver and front end, not optimal for such high resolution. And this is why we are right now looking how to develop this model, because maybe only one tools known for me is SimFOLIVE that not follow rules of other software. No, maybe also your in build most of solver use for meshing your model. If you have, for example, 1 million tets in your model, like here, maybe it's not fully clear. Yes, this model is tetrahedral. It's already a surface model, and you have. And this means if you have here 1 million face element, then measure, frequency domain measure, by definition have already this 1 million. It could get a larger amount, but nevertheless, because it's use already available tests. And this is what we right now investigate, how keeping our resolution in area where we need high precision to get less number of face sets in area where we don't need any kind of precision. And this is clearly not medical, it's more this geometrical exercise how to optimize our setup to get it much, much faster. Because as I mentioned, most of known for me commercial kernel, all based of ASIC kernel, proceed based of your already available face. No chance, because ASIC kernel is designed for such setup. It's first do your face and then doing it. This is exactly the same in CST. I have long discussion with CST also about this story. In frequency domain, once more time, frequency domain. And this is the reason why CST, when we provide to this model to CST, they use first decimation of mesh. Well, they first 4 times decimate mesh and then only able to go through CST. This is what. Okay, thank you for your attention. And I'm...